If you were thirsty right now, what would you do? Me, I would get up and go to the kitchen, get a cup, and put some water in it from my sink. I know all the boys and girls in my class have a kitchen sink in their house. I know if they're thirsty, it's very easy for them to get water. But if you didn't have water in your house, what would you do then? Maybe you could go to a neighbor's house. But what if your neighbor didn't have any water? What happens then? I know where we live, pretty much everybody around here has water. But there are parts, many parts around the world, where it is very difficult to get water. For many people around the world, the only option for them to get water is to carry a bucket miles and miles away from their house. Imagine carrying a bucket that far every day to get water. And you know what? Sometimes that job is done by children, just like you. If you were to carry a big, heavy bucket of water, you might think to carry it in your hands and swing it back and forth and carry it to where you need to bring it. But there's a different strategy. In the book I'm going to read to you today, there is a girl named Anna who's trying to figure out how to carry her bucket of water home.
Anna Carries Water by Olive Senior, illustrated by Laura James. And boys and girls, I apologize because I kept saying the words Anna and Anna. I called her two different things. I didn't know which her name was, and I didn't realize I did both names until I finished making this video. So anyway, here's the story. Anna wanted to carry water on her head more than anything. Her family lived way out in the countryside. Their water did not come from a tap. Every evening after school, the children went to the spring for water. They walked in a straight line. First Doris, then Karen, then Rohan, then Trevor, then Robbie, and last of all, far behind, came Anna. When she got to Mr. Johnson's field, Anna ran to catch them up. Anna was afraid of the cows. The children had different water containers, large metal cans, plastic buckets, and empty cheese tin. Anna was the smallest of all. She had an empty coffee can. Anna was proud that she could carry water. But one thing she couldn't do, she could not carry water on her head. Doris filled her big container first. She floated a dashing leaf on top. Doris walked in with her hands at her sides. Not a drop spilled. Then Karen filled her bottle. Rohan helped her. Not a drop spilled. All the children helped each other. They stood ready to go, all except Anna. They turned to look at Anna. Anna filled her can with water. "Come on, Anna," Doris said. "Just hold it with your two hands." "No," said Anna. "I want to carry it on my head." "You will wet up your clothes," said Rohan. "I won't if I put the leaf in it," said Anna. "Oh, Anna," they all said crossly. Anna picked up a dashing leaf. She tore a little piece off. She put it on top of the water so it wouldn't splash. Anna put the can of water on her head. The can fell off. Anna got wet. She started to cry. "Now see what you have done," said Rohan. Anna cried harder. "Don't cry," said Robbie. He had filled Anna's cup again. "Hold it with your two hands, Anna. Don't put it on your head." "All right," said Anna. The children walked in a straight line home from the spring, across Mr. Johnson's field. They carried the water to their house. Water for cooking and drinking, water for washing dishes, washing faces, cleaning teeth, and for washing dirty feet at night before putting them into clean beds. Water for the animals. They didn't carry water for bathing or washing of clothes. Everyone bathes and washes clothes in the river. Doris took Anna inside to change her clothes. Anna was happy again, but she still wished she could carry water on her head. "As soon as you are old enough to learn, you will learn," Dora said. "But how?" Anna asked. "It just happens," said Karen, "so don't worry." One day, just like any other day, the children went to the spring. They filled their containers and put them on their heads. Anna filled her can and held it tightly. They set off home. First Doris, then Karen, then Rohan, then Trevor, then Robbie, and, last of all, far behind, came Anna. Anna was all alone in Mr. Johnson's field. The cows were lying down. The cows were chewing and chewing. Anna looked at the nearest cow. The cow looked at Anna. Anna was so frightened she didn't think. She just took off. She ran and ran. Meantime, the others had reached home. "Where's Anna?" Mama cried. "Where's Anna?" said everyone. They all rushed over to Mr. Johnson's field. They couldn't believe what they were seeing. Anna ran straight up to her mother. Her father laughed and grabbed the can of water and drank it. Her mother hugged her. "Oh, Anna, you never spilled a drop," she said. "We are proud of you," Papa said. They all shouted, "Hurrah!" Anna was so happy she carried water on her head. She didn't spill a drop. She didn't wet her clothes. She would get a bigger can now. "Hey," Anna said, "what happened to all the cows?"
"What cows?"
"The cows that were chasing me."
"You mean Mr. Johnson's lazy cows?" asked Rohan.
They all started laughing. "Look at the cows, Anna," they said. Anna looked.
The cows were lying on the field, chewing and chewing. Not one had moved. Ha 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 ha, Anna laughed as loudly as the rest. She turned cartwheels with happiness. She didn't feel frightened of anything.
I'm not going to talk too much about the story I just read to you because I really wanted to think about the situation that these people are in and the situation people are in all over the world. Imagine waking up in the middle of the night thirsty and you go to get water, but then you realize you don't have any more water with you at your house. You have to wait until the morning because that is when someone in your house goes to get more water miles and miles away. Imagine what it would be like for you to only have water to eat and drink with, not having water to clean yourself, to clean your clothes, to wash things. How would that make your life different than it is today? The last part of this video shows a clip of a girl about your age or a little bit older and getting water and what it's like for her during the day. So thank you for learning with me and stick around for the clip.
At 1 mile, I wish my day could start like yours. On a gentle walk to school and later to a shopping mall. To the spring, the riverbank, a muddy hole where I collect the dirty water I must drink. I start the 4 mile journey home. A full container on my back. Sometimes I daydream about other children in other countries far away from here. I wonder what the distance is of their daily water walk.